how do these four EV hypercars compare to the new Tesla Roadster? I'm Jonathan Stewart, and welcome to Cleanerwatt. I've seen comparisons made between internal combustion engine hypercars and the Tesla Roadster, but I've not yet seen anyone compare it against other electric hypercars. How does the new Tesla Roadster compare to other EV hypercars, which are 7 to 10 times the cost? The Tesla Roadster is definitely the bargain among the group, but just how many Tesla Roadsters could you buy for each one of these vehicles that we're going to talk about in this video? So for the same cost of one Pininfarina Batista, you could buy 12 and a half Roadsters. For the cost of one Rimac C2, you could buy 10 Tesla Roadsters. For the cost of one Lotus Avea, you could buy 8.5 Tesla Roadsters. And for the cost of one Nio EP9, you could buy 7.4 Tesla Roadsters. So the Tesla Roadster is much cheaper, but how do the specs compare when we look at each vehicle? So the first electric hypercar on the list is the Pininfarina Batista, coming in at $2.5 million. It has been dubbed the most powerful Italian sports car ever. Italian car design firm Pininfarina has a long history of iconic vehicle design, and they have worked with such companies as Ferrari, Alfa Romeo, Fiat, and Maserati. But the Batista is the first Pininfarina-branded hyper-performance car for the company. The Batista has an aggressive exterior design matched with a luxurious and eye-catching interior. Its butterfly doors are sure to attract attention, and its performance is sure to impress. Mechanically, it features four liquid-cooled permanent magnet synchronous electric motors placed at each wheel and a 120 kilowatt-hour battery pack. Its performance is very impressive as well, going from 0 to 100 kilometers an hour in 1.9 seconds, or 0 to 200 kilometers an hour in less than 6 seconds, and 0 to 300 kilometers an hour in less than 12 seconds. It has a top speed of 350 kilometers per hour, or 218 miles per hour, and it can do the quarter mile in 9.1 seconds. Some of the important specs on this vehicle are that it has 1,900 horsepower, it has 2,300 newton meters of torque, its range should be somewhere around 280 miles, and as mentioned before, it has a 120 kilowatt hour battery pack. The Pininfarina Batista will be out as a 2020 model, and they're only going to manufacture 150 total, and as I mentioned, the cost for this vehicle will be right around $2.5 million. The second vehicle on this list is a Rimac C2. Rimac is a Croatian car manufacturer who, besides manufacturing vehicles under its own brand, also develops and produces battery packs, drivetrain systems, and full vehicles for other companies such as Renault, Jaguar, and Aston Martin. Underneath, the Rimac C2 shares much of its core mechanical architecture with the Pininfarina Batista, sharing somewhere around 40 to 50% of the pure technical components between the two vehicles. The exterior of the car is sleek and sure to catch the eye. Like the Pininfarina Batista, it boasts attention-grabbing butterfly doors and has a very aerodynamic design, achieving a coefficient of drag of just 0.28. Mechanically, like the Pininfarina Batista, it features four liquid-cooled permanent magnet synchronous electric motors placed at each wheel with all-wheel drive torque vectoring. The Rimac C2 has 8 onboard cameras, a pair of LiDAR, 6 radar emitters, 12 ultrasonic sensors, as well as an exceptionally precise global positioning system for autonomous driving. Its performance numbers are very impressive as well, going 0 to 100 kilometers an hour in just under 2 seconds and 0 to 60 miles per hour in 1.85 seconds. It will be able to do the quarter mile in 9.1 seconds and should have a top speed of around 258 miles per hour or 412 kilometers an hour. The C2 will have 1,914 horsepower, putting out 2,300 newton meters of torque. It should be able to achieve somewhere around 350 miles of range with the 120 kilowatt hour battery pack. The Rimac C2 will be available as a 2020 model with 150 total being produced, and the price tag is just right around $2 million. The third vehicle on the list is a Lotus Avea, which sells for right around $1.7 million. British car maker Lotus is well known for their hand-built sports cars such as the Elise, which the original Tesla Roadster was built off of. Their newest offering is the Avea, which is the world's first pure electric British hypercar. It is also the world's lightest production EV hypercar, coming in at just 1,680 kilograms or 3,703 pounds, and has a mid-mounted battery pack to mimic the celebrated Lotus mid-engined sports car layout. It has four motors, one at each wheel, and features a 70 kilowatt hour battery pack. According to Lotus, their drivetrain operates at around 98% efficiency, making the most of every electron. Like Tesla, the Avea will be able to receive over-the-air software updates in the future. As far as performance goes, it should be able to go 0 to 100 kilometers an hour in less than 3 seconds. Its top speed should be over 200 miles per hour or 400 kilometers an hour. It's reported to have 1,972 horsepower, 1,700 newton meters of torque, and should have a range of somewhere around 250 miles according to the WLTP cycle. It will be available as a 2020 model with only 130 being produced, and as mentioned, it comes in at around $1.7 million. The fourth vehicle on our list is the Nio EP9, which sells for right around $1.48 million. The EP9 electric hypercar is made by Chinese luxury electric car maker Nio, founded just 6 years ago. In May of 2017, the EP9 set the all-time Nürburgring lap record of 6 minutes and 45.9 seconds, a title that it lost 2 weeks later to the McLaren P1 LM Hybrid. Like the other hypercars that we have mentioned, the EP9 has four individual motors, one at each wheel. This allows for all-wheel torque vectoring for increased track performance. I also found it interesting that the EP9 has twice the downforce of a Formula One car, coming in at right around 2,419 newtons or 4,500 pounds of downforce. This is theoretically enough to drive upside down through a tunnel. As far as performance goes, it goes from 0 to 100 kilometers an hour in 2.7 seconds and 0 to 60 miles per hour in around 2.6 seconds. It can do the quarter mile in 10.2 seconds, has a top speed of 195 miles an hour or 313 kilometers an hour. It has right around 1341 horsepower, 1480 newton meters of torque, and has a range of 265 miles. There have only been 16 Nio EP9s manufactured, and as mentioned, the price is right around $1.48 million. So now we've looked at the competition, four very impressive electric hypercars. But how do they compare to the Tesla Roadster? The least expensive car on the list is the new Tesla Roadster, which will sell for a mere $200,000. Not exactly cheap, but quite a bit less than the other hypercars mentioned so far. It features a removable glass roof which stores in the trunk for an open-air convertible driving experience. Unlike the other hypercars, the Tesla Roadster will have two back seats, making it a four-seater. While you shouldn't expect a lot of legroom in the back seats, it should be sufficient for children. It will feature a three-motor design, two motors in the rear, one in the front, and will have a class-leading 200 kilowatt-hour battery pack, allowing for increased track running time as well as 620 miles of range. In June of 2018, Elon Musk revealed an optional feature called the SpaceX package for the Roadster. The SpaceX package will add cold gas thrusters to the car to improve its maneuverability. The system will include a COPV tank and an electric pump to recharge the air tank. The compressed air will flow through nozzles to generate a cold jet thrust. These thrusters will most likely be used to improve cornering, acceleration, top speed, and braking. Tesla designed this car to give the hardcore smackdown to gas-powered cars, and its reported performance numbers definitely don't disappoint. The car should be able to go 0 to 60 miles per hour in 1.9 seconds or 0 to 100 kilometers per hour in somewhere around 2.1 seconds. It should be able to do the quarter mile in 8.9 seconds, which will make it the first production vehicle to go under 9 seconds for the quarter mile. It has a reported top speed of over 250 miles per hour, and while we do not have the horsepower rating yet, we do know that the at-wheel torque is right around 10,000 newton meters or 7,376 foot-pounds of torque. Do keep in mind that this 10,000 newton meters is not the engine torque, but rather the wheel torque. As mentioned before, it will have over 620 miles of range from a 200 kilowatt hour battery pack. The new Tesla Roadster should be available sometime in 2021, with the first 1,000 vehicles being the Founders Series Tesla Roadsters coming in at 250,000, and the rest of them coming in at around 200,000, and we don't know yet how much the SpaceX package will cost. Tesla has not mentioned how many of these will be manufactured each year, but I assume that thousands of these will be available throughout the years. So here's a spec comparison when you look at these vehicles side by side. When you compare these vehicles with the metrics of cost, horsepower, 0 to 60 mile per hour time, top speed, production numbers, quarter mile time, and battery size, you'll see there that the Tesla Roadster tops at least 4 out of the 7 categories in this list. It has the lowest cost by far at $200,000. We don't yet have the horsepower numbers, so we can't compare that completely. The 0 to 60 time is second on this list, beat only by the Rimac C2. We know the top speed is over 250 miles per hour, so we don't quite know if it's going to be faster than the Rimac C2 or not, which comes in at 258 miles per hour. So for now, we'll call that a Rimac C2 win, but it's possible that it could actually be faster than that, and we'll know when it actually comes out. The Tesla Roadster is really the only car that's going to be made in any kind of large numbers. The Tesla Roadster should also have the lowest quarter mile time, coming in at just 8.9 seconds, and it has the largest battery size at 200 kilowatt hours. So in conclusion, these electric hypercars prove that EVs are not slow and boring, and I believe we need EVs in every category. In the end, the Tesla Roadster is an amazing bargain thanks to the economies of scale and very impressive engineering. I can't wait to see the SpaceX package and track performance of the new Tesla Roadster. Now, really, the end question is, if I was a billionaire and money didn't matter, which car would I buy besides the Tesla Roadster? I would buy the Rimac C2 because I believe it has the best tech, performance, and styling of the other four vehicles. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you learned something and I hope you enjoyed it as well. If you did like the video, please consider clicking the like button so other people can find the video as well. And if you are not yet subscribed to the channel, please consider subscribing so you'll know when future content is published. And if you do subscribe, if you click the bell icon, you'll be notified when I post new videos. Thank you.